Gmail, Outlook.com, and Yahoo Mail are some of the most popular email service providers. However, if you use one of these services, your messages may not be very private or secure. Why? That's because these services have access to the messages you send and also what you receive. That's precisely why you may be seeing some very targeted ads, even if you've never searched for those terms before. Well, in today's video, I'm going to share with you an email alternative which is both private and secure, and the best thing yet is you don't have to give up any of your favorite email features. Hello everyone, Scott Friesen here at Simpletivity, helping you to get more done and enjoy less stress. And here on the Simpletivity YouTube channel, I talk an awful lot about Gmail. However, within the comments section, I see a number of concerns about privacy and security. Questions such as, what exactly is Google collecting from me and what is it doing with all of my personal data? Now, you may be concerned if you're a Gmail user, but this extends to really any completely free service. Let's take a look at a quick example. Here I am within my Outlook.com account, and on the right-hand side, you'll notice that I'm receiving an ad, and it's an ad about a Blue Yeti microphone, something that I actually already own, but something that I've been talking about recently within a number of my videos. So it's obviously picked up on the fact that I've been searching or linking to similar products to this. But even here within my inbox, I've got four emails, right? No, actually, I only have three emails because this top one is actually an ad. Outlook makes it look like an email, makes it very attractive for me to click on this and read it like a regular email, but it's actually an advertisement. Again, something for an ergonomic desk, something else that I've been searching for or mentioning right here within my email account. So why am I being targeted like this? Well, I'm giving up a great deal of my privacy to use their service for free. If you're using anything for free, chances are you are the product, meaning they are using your data to either sell to others or to adjust their needs and give you more direct and targeted ads. Well, I want to introduce you to something that does not do any targeting and keeps your privacy absolutely private. So let me introduce you to Fastmail, secure email for people who care about their privacy. With Fastmail, there is no information sharing, no tracking, and no ads. Your emails are your own with no other prying eyes. Now, I'm actually going to do something a little bit different that I will typically save to the end of my videos, but you're probably wondering about pricing, because if you don't want to be the product, if you want to be an actual customer and own your emails, yes, you will have to pay for the Fastmail service. But look at how affordable Fastmail is. Their basic plan starts at just $3 a month. Now, if you are a Simpletivity viewer, you can go to fastmail.com/simpletivity and get an additional 10% off. I'll also be sure to include this link in the description below. So let's take a closer look at Fastmail. Now, when considering moving from your existing email service provider, you may be thinking that you'll be giving up some features and functionality. However, as we're here within the Fastmail interface, I'm going to show you that you are actually gaining some additional functionality and productivity because Fastmail has combined not only email, but their calendar and their contacts all in the same place, so you don't have to be switching between different apps. Really, all of the features that you have come to expect with your email account are available here. Let me go search for a particular message here and see that even my replies, even my threads look very clean, very straightforward. I can even find my attachments, in my opinion, that much easier than I typically would in my Gmail messages. They're very visible here as I scroll through my inbox. But over here on the right-hand side, we even have a nice sidebar feature. So I can see those attachments here on the right-hand side. I don't even have to be scrolling through to find out where those attachments are. Some other nice benefits of this sidebar is I can quickly look at all of the people who are on this thread. And if I want to look into even more detail about their connections and their contact details, I can do so with a single click, even seeing the other messages that this person has been on. And of course, I've got my calendar available to me here as well, always at the ready. However, unlike Gmail, I've got a better view of both my calendar and my contacts rather than just the sidebar. Because if I come up here to my account, I can go directly into my contacts without opening up a new tab or going anywhere else. Here I can find my contacts, find all of their full details, I would say in a much cleaner and a much more readable layout where I can start to edit and view this information and even see a preview of my most recent emails here down below. And without clicking on a new tab or transitioning to a new screen, I can simply go to my menu and open up my calendar where I have access to all of my appointments and all of my meetings and all of the features, everything that you would come to expect with creating a new event, inviting others is all here within Fastmail. So you're not giving up those features or that functionality that you're used to from your existing email or calendar client. Now, because Fastmail is all about privacy and security, one of my favorite features has to do with keeping your email address safe. How many times have you wanted to sign up for a new service or a newsletter or maybe just get that discount when you're checking out from a store, but you don't want to give your actual email address? Or maybe you don't want to give your business address to the contact form or other areas of your webpage. Well, what Fastmail allows us to do is to create more than 500 aliases. What's an alias? Well, it's allowing you to create additional email addresses, which you can receive right here within a single inbox. Let me show you how it works. I'm going to go over here to my settings, and then I'm going to click on users and aliases. So here is my actual Fastmail account here, scottfriesen@fastmail.com. Now note, you can bring over any email account that you want from any other service, including your own domain name. So you do not need to use a fastmail.com domain name. But down below, there's a section called aliases, and I haven't created one just yet. So let me show you how to do so. I'm going to select new alias. And in this case, I'm going to choose something like Scott's inbox. So this is going to be an email address that I'm going to send out, maybe post on my website, or just give to people that I'm not sure if I want them to have access to my direct account or to my direct email address. This can also be a great way to keep track of who is doing what with your information. So here you can see I've got the email here, scottsinbox@fastmail.com, but anything that someone sends this to is going to be delivered to my primary account. I'm going to hit save here, and I can create as many of these aliases as I want. So if you run your own business or your own website, consider the different ways in which you could use aliases. You could have one for info, one for admin, one for support. So you already know what that user or what that sender is looking for, even though you're collecting that information all from a single inbox. And if you're worried that Fastmail may not have a mobile app, don't fret. Fastmail has a clean and very fast app, which, unlike Google, gives you access to both contacts and calendar from the exact same app. So you don't have to be jumping between those apps to be as productive as you want to be. If you'd like to try Fastmail free for 30 days and get 10% off your first year, go to fastmail.com/simpletivity. Thank you so much for watching today's video. And remember, being productive does not need to be difficult. In fact, it's very simple.